concept for the album is like a sampled feel to live music. It's almost like we're trying to treat live music like hip hop loops and like samples and shit. So we're kind of sampling ourselves in a way. So it's like the merging of, I don't want to say like hip hop and rock because it's not that rock oriented at all. It's more like a hip hop.
It's good. Riding music is good. Smoking music is good. Drinking music is good. Chilling music. The overall vibe of it is like really controlled, rawness, like dope way of putting all of our music together.
It's kind of a reassuring process. The way that we envisioned it working works and sounds probably better than we expected. It's nice to see everybody using the shit that needs to be on the track.
Yeah. I got 2 15s in the trunk. 7 grams all in the blunt. One dime piece in the back. We three gold rappers when I smash. 18's all on the whip though. I keep them stocked cause I really don't trip though. Yeah, I'm swinging like Klitschko, rolling through your city and I bet your whole click now. And it's going well so far and the process has been really cool. We rented a house for a week just outside of Joppa, Maryland. Threw on some kung fu flicks with the subtitles on and spraining ankles. Smoking lots of pot, talking about how many girls we fuck all the time. That kind of stuff. You know, stuff bands do.
It was an interesting week. Late nights, early mornings, very little sleep, lots of coffee. It was a lot of fun. It's the most fun I've had in a long time, hanging out with these guys for a week and just kind of locking ourselves in there.
My favorite part is like right when you're starting to hear it, like right when it's starting to come through. The hardest part of finishing any project is like the last 10%. But the right before you hit that 90%, when like you're throwing all the muscles on the skeleton and you can see like, you know, like what it is that you're building. To me, that's my favorite part, besides actually finishing it and then it being done.
It really is co-mingling of my style with Vince and Bill and Bob's production style. It's cool when those two come together because you really do have a new brand of hip hop.
Chill. That's right. Yeah, I let that beat go. Two songs, I let that beat get up. Don't crush a motherfucker, never shook. Bet 100 on myself to see if I'm good. Trump City in that house up. Freezing out Friday.
You can feel every instrument, you can feel like every person's part of it. And when you, even when you look at the session file in Logic and see all the tracks that are in it, and just like you see there's 60 tracks that have been put into the 60 little pieces of love thrown into this thing that is all meshed down into one MP3 or whatever. It's just really cool because, like, you know, everybody's responsible for a certain portion of that. And
we've lived together a lot, so all the beats can be pretty organic. We're just making beats every day, made in this style where it was like a lot of loop based ideas mixed with live drums that we tracked out and looped, and then we kind of use that sound to shape the rest of the sounds that we're gonna do on the record.
Layer on layer of hip hop like flavor, all done with these live instruments, and then still with the layer of synthetic drums and everything else. And it's just really like, it's just nice to use all your resources. That's the way that you're being like most fair to your like listener. Like, you should be using all your resources. You should use every possible thing you think's best. Everything at your fingertips. And I think that's kind of like what we've done with this album. You know, like, if autotune sounds good on the track, fuck, it sounds good on the track.
Well, I tell you what, you gonna play that riff, you ride it out, you get the pussy dancing, you get the guys buying drinks for them, and I tell you what, man, you stop playing, pussy stops dancing, everyone goes home, all right? And you lose money.
Lose respect.
Or lose respect.